Dear friends, the Federation of Cuban Women greet the celebration of this meeting in honor to 60th anniversary of our organization. My name is Gretel Maranta Rossett, and I am a French affair of the Cuban Women Federation. The Cuban Women Federation is a national social organization that was created on August 23, 1960. Thanks to support and dedication to Vilma Espín and Fidel Castro. The responsibility for this task was assigned to Vilma Espín Guillot, who since its creation led the organization. Since the very beginning of revolution, our eternal commander-in-chief Fidel Castro said, "Women in Cuba is a revolution within another revolution." The Cuban women consider that the revolution is the first equality program for Cubans. Since its establishment on August 23, 1960, the Federation of Cuban Women has designated its objectives the prevention work with the fundamental action with the women and the family, based on an important social and educational work, and effective as essential objective in the work of prevention and social care from the FMC, where the house focuses on women and the family, a counseling house, a meeting place to work, think, learn, share, enjoy, train, receive guidance and support through some professional and specialist. It has three main lines: individual counseling, group counseling, and job trainer, where course, seminar, workshop, people for the community are held. The Cuban Women Federation is a clear expression of unity of all the Cuban women. We contend that more than 4 million of affiliates, that it represents more than 91% of the women older 14 years old. We can proudly say that today women in Cuba enjoy the full exercise of human rights. Our social projects guarantee the access of all human beings to education, culture, health, and especially attention to people in a universal way and free, without exclusion by sex, skin color, or religion. Referring to the issue of equality, non-discrimination, and gender perspective, the Cuban Constitution dedicates a chapter with several articles, in particular the 41, 42, and 43, to establishment the provisions related to equality, equal rights, and duties are guaranteed for all citizens, allowing all forms of discrimination. Remember that Cuba was the first country to sign and the second to ratify the Convention on the Elimination of All Forms of Discrimination Against Women. In terms of labor rights, it is worth emphasizing that we Cubans receive the same salary for work of equal value. From our experience to achieve the equality of rights and opportunities between men and women, it is necessary to develop a real culture for equality, that is the creation of the appropriate material infrastructure, social development, and also the participation of women. Gender mainstream in Cuba reflects the political will of the government, which has fostered the strengthening of mechanisms and regulation integrated in a system that recognizes the common and the specific of gender perspective regarding the situation of men and women in the society. I think that our structure in all the levels helps us to know what is the problem of each woman. The grassroots level is a particular scene for the Federate. The Federation of Cuban Women has been recognized by the government and the society as a national mechanism for the advantage of women due to its extensive work at the grassroots level, its role in the introduction of gender concept in the institutional agenda and the public policies, its work for the complete integration of women to economical, social, and political and cultural life in the country, the Cuban Women Federation has a legislative power. This condition to bring us the possibility to promote laws and public policy with gender perspective. Another important moment in the process of the introducing gender mainstream in public policy was the adoption of the decree law in 1997 of the National Plan of Action of the Republic of Cuba to follow up of the 4th UN World Conference to the on Women in Beijing 1995. This national plan of action systematized what had been achieved up to that moment and the project for the future. The FMC has got a special consultative status with ECOSOC at the United Nations since 1997. This facilitates our participation in the council session and also its functional commission, fundamentally in the Commission of the Status of Women and the Human Rights Council. It is also enable us to present periodic oral and written contribution regarding to work of our organization. The Federation of Cuban Women is also a member of many international movements and organizations, such as the Women International Democratic Federation, the Conference of the NGO, the International Council of Social Welfare, and the World Women March, among others. The Federation of Cuban Women coordinates the regional office of the International Democratic Women Federation to organize the work of the women organization in Latin America and the Caribbean. The work of the FNC and the Cuban Women Advance has been consolidated in spite of the injust politics of economics, commercial, and financial blockade effect imposed by the government of the United States to Cuba that has a particular impact in the women and their families. Cuba is ours. It belongs to the Cuban people, and we will continue as an example of the free and sovereign nation. Thank you very much.